Hello viewers, if you are new to the channel, please hit the like and subscribe button and share it with your friends. Also, click on the bell icon so that you get the latest information about the videos that are uploaded. Hello students, welcome back to the new video. In this video, we are going to continue the ongoing chapter number 12, Reproduction in Plants. In today's session, we will discuss about seed dispersal and germination of seeds. Seed dispersal. Most plants produce a large number of seeds. This is to ensure the continuation of species. In nature, not all seeds germinate, and the ones that germinate may be eaten away or destroyed before they grow into mature plants. So, all the plants produce a large number of seeds. What is the reason for that? This is to make sure that the continuation of the species take place. What is the reason? Because in nature, all seeds are not germinating, and if at all it is germinated, many of them may be eaten away or destroyed by the other plants, other animals, before they grow into matured plants. Seed dispersal is the scattering of the seeds away from the parent plant over a large area by different means. This helps the plant to grow in new regions. If all the seeds were to fall close to the mother plant, they would not be able to grow well as they would not receive enough space, sunlight and nutrient. So what is the definition of seed dispersal? It is the process of scattering of the seeds away from the parent plant. It can take place by different means. Now, what is the use of seed dispersal? It helps the plant to grow in new regions. And do you know, if all the plants produce many seeds, and if all the seeds are supposed to fall on the same place or just below the mother plant, then what would happen? They would not, all the seeds will not get enough space or enough sunlight and nutrients. That means there will be a struggle for existence. As a result, some would not even survive. That is why seed dispersal is an important aspect of the plant life. Seed dispersal helps the plants to prevent overcrowding, avoid competition for sunlight, water and minerals, and invade new habitats. These are the benefits of seed dispersal, because seed dispersal prevent or avoid overcrowding and also avoid the competition for sunlight, water, minerals, etc. And because of the seed dispersal, plants get the new habitats. Seed dispersal is carried out by various agents such as wind, water, animals and explosion of fruits. Let us see all these agents one by one. Now we will see the wind dispersal. Some seeds are carried away to a new place by the wind. Such seeds are generally small and lightweight. Some of them have tuft of hair or wing-shaped structures to help them disperse to different places. The seeds of grasses, drumsticks, maple, cotton and dandelion are dispersed by wind. So, as the name indicates, the seeds which are dispersed by the wind are light in weight and they are generally small. Some of them have the special structures called wing-shaped structures or tuft of hair which help them to move into different places through wind. Examples are the seeds of grasses, drumsticks, maple, cotton, dandelion, etc. Now, let us discuss water dispersal. These seeds have a spongy coat or a layer of fiber to help them float on water. For example, the lotus fruit is spongy and floats easily. Coconuts can travel miles across seas and oceans as they have air trapped between the fibers of the outer husk. See, the seeds which are dispersed by water have the special spongy coat or a layer of fiber which help them to float on the water. Example, lotus and coconut. Coconuts can travel even miles together because they have air-trapped fibers on the outer husk. Now we will discuss about animal dispersal. Some animals and birds eat fruits along with the seeds. The seeds remain undigested and are sent out along with the excreta. These seeds then germinate into new plants. Some animals such as mice and squirrels bury seeds of plants such as oak and walnuts under the soil. So, the dispersal by the animal takes place when the birds and small animals eat the fruits along with the seeds and they are sent out along with the excreta. When the favorable conditions are available, these seeds germinate into new plants. Later, these seeds germinate during favorable conditions and give rise to new plants. The seeds or fruits of some plants such as cockleburr, that is xanthium, have hooks or burrs which easily get caught in the fur of animals or clothes of human beings as they pass by the plants. These seeds are thus carried to far off places. The seeds or fruits of some plants such as cockleburr, name is xanthium, they have hooks or burrs which can easily get stuck in the clothes of human beings or on the fur of animals. In that way, they get carried away to the far off places. Now we will see explosive dispersal. In some plants, the fruits burst open with great force, scattering the seeds inside it. Explosive dispersal is seen in balsam, castor and pea plants. Here, when the fruits becomes matured, they burst open with great force and thus throw away the seeds into various places. This is known as dispersal by explosion. Examples are balsam, castor and pea plants. Now we will discuss about the germination of seeds. Germination is the process of developing seeds into new plants. Once the seeds are scattered, they need certain environmental conditions for their growth. Usually, this is determined by how deep the seed is planted, water availability, air, soil and temperature. You know what is germination? Germination is the process of developing seeds into new plants. Once when the seeds are scattered or move away from the mother plant, and when the favorable conditions like the temperature, water availability, air and the nutrient soil is available, the seeds grow into new plants. When all these conditions become favorable, the seed starts germinating into a baby plant with the help of food stored in the seeds. When water is taken by seed, it activates the enzymes present in it. These enzymes change the stored food into the soluble form and diffuses it into radical and plumule for growth. So, when the conditions are available, what changes takes place in the seeds? The baby plant get the food with the help of the food stored in the seeds, and when water is taken by the seed, the enzymes present in it get activated and change the stored food into the soluble form and diffuses it into radical and plumule for growth. That is, root system and shoot system starts developing. The radical starts growing first and becomes the root. Then the plumule starts growing and forms the shoot. Once the baby plant starts growing, it makes its own food by the process of photosynthesis. After germination, the radicals of the seed convert into root system and plumules develop into shoot system. When the baby plant starts growing, then it starts making its own food by the process of photosynthesis. So students, I hope you have understood the topics very well. But still, if you have any doubt, you can write in the comment section. I will surely try to solve it as early as possible. Here are some review questions. Please solve it in your notebook. Thank you.